spaceship. I swear my life is amazing. No money, no hesitation. There's no basis. I know they be hating, but that's what made me.
Feel like in the real life, dreaming all the stars in the good life.
Like a right now, I do this for my rounds. Oh yeah.
My have an all white ring. Couldn't hit if that ain't. Lanes can't call and you lame. You had it and you lost it, all the shame. I can buy a Billy, don't talk to me. For a show 150, don't talk to me. You ain't never helped your mans, don't talk to me. You just follow all the trends, don't talk to me. I set the bar, I'm the bar. Look in the sky, I'm a star. I don't fall in love, cause I be loving. They ain't like my shirt, it's a large. I don't care, I crush a ghost. Got two cribs and two states, I be doing the most. I got white folks money that I won't blow. And if you ask why, cause the white folks don't.
Big bank, tight, low bank, bank. Big bank, tight, low bank, bank. The type of money you gon' need to sight. Type of money you gon' need to buy. From the hood, this type of money make you stay away. Type of money gon' let you. Big bank tight, low buy. Big bank tight, low buy.
Everything proper, no propaganda. Chopper count a gold yard bandana. Big, a lot of like Santa. Threw a birthday party in a phantom. Big, like a dinosaur did it. And you know, shining like acrylic. Yeah, I had cornrows. I can see you hanging with the door closed. Now I'm looking for a glove with a sparkle on it. And my got chocolate on it. Big bank, take small. Bank account on some talk. Attitude on some. Bank roll on what it do, boo. He had the rule at five. And if I ain't did it yet, I'll try.
Big bank, tight, low, bank, bank. Big bank, tight, low, bank, bank. Type of money you gon' need to sight. Type of money you gon' need to buy. From the hood, this type of money make you stay away. Type of money gon' let you. Big bank tight, low bank. Big bank tight, low bank.
She said, what you gon' do if I leave? I said, I'ma do me. B-I-G, everything zoomed in. Big homie looking like I'm moving in. Got my foot in the door and we still here. I'm a first generation millionaire. I broke the curse of my family not having. I'm passionate like just after more than just cashing. Feed me to the wolves, now I lead the packing. You boys all cap, I'm more Colin Kaepernick. I'm rare as affordable healthcare. Or going to wealth from welfare. I turn my W's to, yeah, I those. I might buy a red bottoms with the crypto. Three coins, that'll pay a whole semester. But you gotta bet it in a Tesla.
Big bank, tight, low, buy, buy. Big bank, tight, low, buy, buy. Type of money you gon' need to sight. Type of money you gon' need to buy. From the hood, this type of money make you stay away. Type of money gon' let you. Big bank, tight, low, buy, buy. Big bank, tight, low, buy.
Back again, back to back, made back, stacked it. I'm in Slim Shady, baby, the M. Once he black, he'll be back again. Tell him that it's crunch time, abdomen. Yes, I caught Mad Chanel and Mad Javin. She did it again, imagine them. About to make these bums mad again. Uh-oh. Back to them. I lead the pack, so my back's to them. Yup, the queen's back, what's happening? Rerun, about to make these rap again. Diamond chains on my ankle. Young money in the cut like a tell tip, rubber bands on my bankroll. Show my like a
big bank tight, low bank, bank. Big bank tight, low bank, bank. Type of money you gon' need to sight. The type of money you gon' need to buy. From the hood, this type of money make.
Bring out the Brinks truck, I'm young, flying ice up. 100 yards. club with the owner. I can walk on water, pop it like, hey, when you on top, gon' hate on you, that what they supposed to do, I don't know how to lose. I think the Rari go faster without the roof. Hey, when you on top, gon' hate on you, that what they supposed to do, I don't know how to lose. I think the Rari go faster without the roof. Chill. 30, I might go around in 2 seconds up, I love how my money counter move. With attitude, I got a bit to, and I dropped out of school. I'm going up, check my vertical. Man, I'm breaking every rule. TMZ harassing me, I got a camera crew. Whoa. I'm addicted to shopping, so everything brand new.
Everything brand new, yeah.
I'm friends with the jeweler, my diamonds like Shamu.
My diamonds like Shamu.
Hey, she like she applying shampoo.
Yeah.
Pretty face, she got a look.
She got a look. Yeah.
Keep a few racks on me, I used to work in the factory. Been hating it, never bother me. I make they follow me. Teacher said that I'm a prodigy. When I'm shopping, I don't care what it's costing me. 10 bands, really, that ain't a lot to me. Turn up my swag to infinity.
Damn.
I leveled up on it.
Level
yeah, I leveled up.
Ooh.
I bezeled up on it.
Yeah,
I bezeled up. Ooh. I ain't got top of no negative energy. Ooh. I'm on a winning streak. I'm on a
free.
The devil be doing the most, but he don't ever get to me. Bring out the Brinks truck. I'm young, flying ice up. 100-yard dash. I had to run my price up. Bought your life up. I had to boss mine up. $10,000 outfit, $100. Hey, when you on top, don't hate on you, that what they supposed to do, I don't know how to lose. I think the Rari go faster without the roof. Hey, when you on top, don't hate on you, that what they supposed to do, I don't know how to lose. I think the Rari go faster without the roof.
Chill.
Money back. Money back. Money back. Make it like a money back. Money back.
God, I do the math back on Monday. So rock me Friday. This is sweet. Daddy, that just was classic. I said, babe, it's a, he said, it's a, them pretty. You look like Beyonce. Looking like money back, money back, money back.
This is sweet, daddy, one in the bag, bubbling. Look at the cash, look at the cash coming in. Come get your man, slip, booger bugging me. Just need a bag, quit all that jaw jaggering. Don't need to be that, I don't want none of it. He's bad about it, had enough of it. Whoa, watch what you saying, how that popping is shaking. Got me is a laser, my pass is deep and I rate it. We act the fool for the paper, had a dream and I made it. El Camino on Dayton's, bitches guess over bait. Put the brand on me, bet on my bacon. Pick it flat in the bacon, I might just roll out today. I might just roll out to Vegas, head back to my old ways. Cop a roof on you for all day. Look at me, baby. Look at me, baby. Don't I look like a million? I'm about to clean out the safe. Don't I look like somebody that just be bodying and everything? All that talking is great, but I don't be talking. I air it out. All the problems have gotten easy to bury. I'd rather kiss on my. I've been broke away longer than I've been rich, though, until it levels out. I'ma take mama to the Marriott. Took me so long to get it, gonna spread it out. Let them know all about me when I'm dead and gone. One in the hand, one in the bag, bubba. One in the hand, one in the bag, bubba. Look at your cash, look at the cash, bubba. Look at your cash, bubba. One in the hand, one in the hand. I'ma need all the fries you can give me, all the hot sauce, all the pie you can give me. Better be all or nothing, don't have me in the middle. You better be all you can, yeah, yeah, yeah. Super fly for the Dumbos, plenty slides like a shuffle. Hit the cadence on my young girl, Isaac Hayes, Billy Ocean. About the old with the cane stick, let my slippers at the function. It's hard to run the Gucci slides, that bitch you say you didn't ever. I'ma stab no, Jackie Chan, no travel. Can't clean it with the beanie, dripping from the. No, Lord, not me. I can never be the one you want to stuff for. Money, that machine. The bell got my soul. R.I.P. the times that I was broke. Out in life in 9/11, folks. Matt Black, liquor clean. Dead places in and I'm a local. Cooking up canard. Waiting for the antidote. Running out of time. Patience in it, then a penny, ho.
I don't do that. In my preschool, you know what I tell you? Get over it. He's going to get there.
One in the hand, one in the bag, bubba. One in the hand, one in the bag, bubba. Look at your cash, look at your cash, bubba. Look at your cash, bubba. One in the hand, one in the hand. One in the hand, one in the bag, bubba. Look at your cash, look at your cash, bubba. Look at your cash, bubba.
Two, two. forever. Forever, man. I mean that.
Welcome all of you to Nissan Stadium on the banks of the Cumberland River in downtown Nashville, Tennessee. The whole of downtown Nashville likely still reverberating with the sounds of the Titans taking the field a moment ago. They're ready for football as their Titans are set to match up with the Indianapolis Colts. Here we go, the final week of the NFL season, week 17, is underway. Fielded about a yard deep. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. The 20. He lost six there on the first down play.
I know the scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker. And what that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
On second down, here's Taylor. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. He was looking for Brashad Perriman, and it's third down.
I think he's a little trigger happy right there, and it turned into an ill-advised throw into their zone.
Well, we know he has confidence. He'll throw it any place, anytime, anywhere. That time it fell incomplete. And I don't think this is the script they had in mind for their opening drive. This is third and long. Taylor. Now the pressure comes and he goes down. Just inside the 10, back at the 9. Jarrell Casey in there to get him, and that's sack number 8 for him on the year. Now here's Rigoberto Sanchez as his first punt will come from inside his own end zone. And this is away. It's a high kick, and he got all of it. This is fielded at the 27. A great return there of 22 yards, and it'll be Titan football. The fourth down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down. First down, Mariota. And incomplete to open things up.
Defensively here, you're facing a top five team in terms of points scored in the NFL. So when they're that high power, you've got to find a way to hold them under 20. Because to me, that's the magic number. 20 points scored, give yourself your best chance to win.
So if they're up around 24, 28, 30, they could be in some trouble.
And I think so, because then you turn it into a shootout, and that means your offense has to keep pace.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. From the gun, Mariota. Buying time to his left. Mariota had an 87-yard run as a rookie. This one a bit less, but it is a first down.
That was an excellent job of recognizing the situation. His first read wasn't there. Heck, his second read wasn't there. But he bought himself a little extra time scrambling out of the pocket, got to the sticks, and picked up the first down.
Now a first carry for Derrick Henry. He'll fight forward for a couple down inside the 40.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, this big defensive lineman will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
One.
Second down, Mariota. And this one caught by Dez Bryant. 17 yards on that play for the Titans.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and get the quarterback a really nice target.
And he's going to be taken down here. A sack back at the 32. Jabal Sheard in there to drop him for his 11th sack of the year. So second and long, and got to be careful not to fall out of field goal range. Working out of the gun, Mariota. And his throw is incomplete. Dez Bryant, the intended receiver. And now it's third down.
When you see passes knocked down by those guys I call the frustrated fullbacks, the linebackers, you know that in their zone coverage, they were able to drop, see the ball thrown, and react to it very quickly.
Forced out to his left. And that one drops incomplete as he got popped as he was throwing it.
It's a great job by this secondary. When I watch them, they remind me of elite defenders on a basketball court, right? They want to contest each and every pass.
Great contest on third down to bring up fourth. These kickers now, it used to be that a 50-plus yarder was cause for celebration, now seemingly automatic.
Yeah, isn't it funny? When we prepare for a game, when you look at the backgrounds of these kickers, it's interesting, isn't it, to find out they were All-State quarterbacks, receivers, defensive backs, All-State wrestlers, right? Baseball players. We're finding athletes all along, and now they're just special.
Now a hit and a loose football. It's picked up by the Titans, and his guys are going to get the football at the 28-yard line. And careless with a football there on the kick return.
And one thing I love about going to practices is trying to get around coaches and hear their catchphrases and what they really emphasize. We haven't been to a single one yet this year where a guy fielding a kick, you don't hear, tuck it away, tuck it away, tuck it away. And this time, they turned it over.
Ball security eluded him. Now, meanwhile, a pass that should have been intercepted, but it winds up falling incomplete. So now they'll come up on second and 10, once again from the 28. Deion Lewis, the first carry for the ex-Patriot. And he's going to bring this one down to right about the 20-yard line. A nice job to get eight there after the incompletion, and now they'll look at a third and two coming up. Mariota on third and two. Pressure applied, and he's going to be taken down. They sack him back at the 33-yard line. Keenan Robinson. Able to get him down for a loss of 11 on the play. And it'll be fourth down. And Succop will put this one right through. And that'll make it 6-0 here in the first. So scores on their first two possessions, but 6-0, so field goals probably not what they were hoping for.
Now, you're exactly right about that. Not what they were hoping for, but they should be happy that they have points on the board. It almost feels like that old slow and steady wins the race, doesn't it? In this case, though, they want to be slow and steady now, but get explosive later and put the points up on the board.
And now Indianapolis set to take the field. Even though they might not find the number one seed next to their name come playoff time, there's not going to be very many teams, if any, entering the playoffs on the kind of run they're on. They're hot.
And I love that word, hot, because every team in the league wants to go into the playoffs on that uptick. Because a lot of the time, you serve notice to the rest of the league that, hey, we're the team you need to deal with. We're the team that's going to be a real problem for you. If they can continue this streak, they could very well be that team and gain that confidence that they're seeking as they head to the playoffs.
And confidence, that's the word I would use from our meetings with them. They said we're playing our best football right now. It is showing. After the loss to start out, here's 2nd and 11. Now Taylor to throw on 2nd down. Got a man. It's Prashan Perriman. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for 3rd down. And a flag, and I think we got a jump here. So jumping from his free safety spot.
That tells you how aggressive they are on defense, doesn't it? They get everyone involved. He was a little too fast on that play.
So forget the throwing it out. The penalty makes this 1st and 10. Now it's Hines, and very little daylight there. He'll get a couple up to the 44.
Well, he was looking for some running room, and there wasn't a whole lot of it there on that play. I think he was lucky to get a couple of yards out of it because those defenders, they were rallying to the football pretty quickly.
The first carry for the rookie, it's Jordan Wilkins. Yeah, he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair.
I know when I was a kid, I always got real excited when I saw those lateral-type runs. But the best backs that made it happen, they put a foot in the ground and just go. That didn't happen there. That play got swallowed up.
On 3rd down, Taylor. And he connects with Ebron. Now he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. That one goes for 24 yards.
I know exactly what's going to be said about that play from the defensive perspective.
What's that?
That's why I tell all you guys we need more than one tackler to the ball. He broke the first tackle. Luckily enough, there were more people there to get him down.
From the 34 now, here's 1st and 10. Throwing now, Taylor on 1st down. On the right side, it's Hilton with a catch. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another 1st down. Just the first quarter, but tackling going to be so important going forward. They've got to limit plays like that.
And that's something when you see it happen early in the game and they don't get him on the ground, you can always tell that they were concerned about it going in. Because I can just tell you from my days, I remember being in college and worrying all offseason about our season open opponent. And they had a receiver that could shake and bake with the best of them. I tackled him on the first pass of the game, and the relief was incredible.
And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Indianapolis. T.Y. Hilton, his 6th touchdown of the season. And the Colts have tied things up. They can take the lead with the extra point. Vinatieri connecting on the extra point. And they take the lead here at 7-6. Vinatieri out there to kick this one away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. And the Titans getting set to go. They've been settling quite a bit. They've been able to move the football some, but they've just been settling. That's one of the reasons they're down on the scoreboard.
I love that word you picked, settling, because nowadays in this NFL, You're thinking touchdown almost every drive because everything's so high-powered. Yeah, you take the field goal, but you always feel like you're leaving points out there when you don't put it in the end zone.
They'll be trying to put it in the end zone here on this drive. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and eight.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here, and if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs, run some plays, run some clock.
Trying here for Bryant, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 33. And he'll take this across midfield and inside the 45.
Okay, it's real simple to say from here, but we know that sometimes as a quarterback, you've got to know when to say when and just throw it away. Flushed out to the right, tries to make something out of nothing here, and he winds up floating one downfield. It gets intercepted.
Here's Hines on a toss play. And past the 35, he'll be dropped a yard or two shy of the 30. A gain of 11 that time and a Colts first down.
Usually we see runs like this as the defense breaks down later in the game, but this guy is setting the tone early, running through all types of tackles and putting the defense back on its heels.
Slow, slow, slow.
On first and 10, it's Taylor. To the right side to Eric Ebron. No gain there on the completion, second and 10.
Well, that was a simple throw and catch, but even with that completion, 0 yards gained. So they're behind schedule on down and distance.
I think they were hoping to get it to him. He could make a man or two miss, but that window closed quickly. Had the completed pass, but for no gain, stopped right at the line, so it's second and 10. And he gets stopped up at the 31 after a gain of maybe a yard.
Well, so many times we look at a short run and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things, but the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. It wasn't a big run given up. They don't always have to absorb the body blows. Sometimes they dish them out themselves.
Slipped one tackle, but no more as he's knocked to the deck behind the line of scrimmage. That'll make it fourth down after a loss of one.
I like the strategy. Extra tight ends, extra beef. They want to run the football, but that means they probably want to run it inside. If you get strung out on the perimeter, you're in peril.
Yeah, we saw the result, negative yardage. And Vinatieri's kick is good. And they bump the lead up to four now at 10-6. So a good kick there, and they put the bow tie on it with 3 points.
And let's face it, everybody wants a touchdown. We know that. But in the NFL, defenses are awfully good. You're not going to score each and every time. Be able to knock the ball through the post and take the three.
By the way, I said bow tie. I meant just bow. Not the tie, but yeah.
Either way.
You got it.
I just went right past it.
The Titan offense now working their way back onto the field. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. Here's second and 7 now from the 28. Now a second down throw for Mariota. He finds Corey Davis. Touchdown, Titans. A big play there. His fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Titans get the quick strike touchdown. Great corner out there. Not only able to catch it, turn it upfield, and get into the end zone.
It usually involves a little bit of an extra move, doesn't it? You've got to get them thinking that you're moving to the middle of the field and you're breaking away to that corner. Boy, that was well executed.
This is taken about 7 yards deep. And a nice job there as he gets this one up just shy of the 35-yard line at the 34. And now Indianapolis set to take the field. And after the field goal last time, we'll see what they can get here. At least they got points out of the last drive, Charles.
I never met an offensive coach that didn't want a drive to end with a kick. Most of them want it end with a PAT, right? In this case, a field goal, they'll take it. Way better than the alternative, which is a punt.
Yeah, but you met fan bases that wanted that, that weren't happy with that field goal.
I haven't met a fan base yet that wants to drive in with a kick other than the extra point. That's it.
Quickly. He gets it across the 35 to the 36-yard line. The tackle was by the Boston College product, Harold Landry.
Well, he hasn't made much of an impact in the running game thus far, and after that last run, not much is going to change in that area.
He hasn't been able to get anything going, and really the offensive line not helping him much. On third down, that's Hines, and he maybe makes it back to the line of scrimmage. That's it. Call it no gain there, and it leads to a fourth down.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. This will be taken at the 10. A very good return that time. 18 yards, and that will come the offense as they take over. And here comes Tennessee as they get set to take the field. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked. But you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
High throw, but he makes the catch. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion.
Nothing fancy on first down, but a very consistent type of a play. Hit that slant. A lot of people call it an extension of the running game, and it can be if that pass is completed.
The Colts are going to get him. Down he goes.
Brandon, if I'm an offensive coordinator and I see an all-out rush like that, I file it away because I'm going to use their aggressiveness against them as this game goes on. I'm going to hit them with a screen soon.
Mariota will need a big play after the sack as the Titans come up third and long. Mariota to throw it. He completes it to Bryant. Fighting through, and he's got space. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. And they're able to convert on third with a solid gain of 23. From the shotgun, it's Mariota. Going for the deep ball. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked off with great anticipation. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. And he may want to track down that football because that's interception number one on his career.
You're saying that's going into the trophy case?
I'd put it there.
Yeah, no doubt about it. That's when you ask the equipment guys to make sure they hold it for you after the game. But if you turn the back seven on defense, that's part of your job, finding ways to take the ball away from the other team.
Wesley Woodyard there on the tackle. Second and 9 now from the 21. On second down, Taylor. He completes it to Julio Jones. And they're able to get this one across the 35. First catch so far for Julio. He's got a first down.
I think it all came together there. In-breaking route. Drove it with excellent pace. Money throw right there to move the sticks.
Now Taylor on first down. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. 5 yards on the pickup, and that'll bring up second down.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
Looking to throw on second down. Taylor over the middle, complete. It's Doyle. And he'll get it out to midfield. Looks like, yeah, they'll spot it right at midfield at the 50. His first catch, good for 9 and a first down.
Sometimes the most effective routes are the ones that you run in the backyard. You probably ran them when you were 5 years old. How about a little curl there against zone? But the key to it is finding the open spots in the zone. How a linebacker or a defense. defensive back will widen to give you space. Find that area, let your quarterback hit you.
Yeah, give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and six. Under four to go now as the clock runs and they come up on second down. Play action. Now Taylor. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Brian Arakpo. In there to bring him down for a loss of seven. Third and long. Taylor and company hoping to regroup after the sack. From the gun, it's Taylor. And that is incomplete. Good coverage that time by Malcolm Butler.
Certainly looked like they were getting ready to convert there on third down, but what an effort to get his hand on that one, knock it away, and brings up a fourth down decision.
Yeah, he's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. But fortunately, he's able to recover his own fumble, or that could have been trouble.
I know there's no magnet in the ball, but sometimes for the punt returner, after such a scramble, it sort of feels that way, doesn't it? He has it, he loses it, somehow the ball finds its way back to him.
Atone for his sin, and you know he's taking a deep sigh of relief right now. Trying to shake off the interception, he'll look to throw. Out left side here to Bryant. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. 23 yards on the play. One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. Now contact up front as penalty markers come in. Who is this against? A free 5 yards as the defense jumps.
I know it's an anticipation game for them, but it's also a reaction game, and they reacted poorly on that one.
Now a chance to make that encroachment penalty really hurt. First and 5. Now Mariota steps away to his left, and it's incomplete. One of his main targets, Delanie Walker, the intended receiver, and it's second down.
I would say it'd probably be a good idea for him to reintroduce himself to his receivers at the half because they're definitely on different wavelengths. But I also don't advocate waiting that long. Next series before you get out there. Hey, let's get together, guys. Let's get this thing moving.
That'll be a loss of a yard, and it leads to a third down.
Part of the thinking when you bring in extra tight ends, you're hoping that each of your guys gets those one-on-one blocks and creates a crease for your runner. But the converse is, though, you've got to win those one-on-one blocks. And when you don't, that's the result you end up with.
Here's Mariota dancing to his left. And he locates Walker complete. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. A good pick up there, 26 yards.
One.
2 minutes remain here in the first half. Back to Tennessee after this. Mariota on first down. Sets up the screen to Lewis. And they'll work it inside the 15-yard line before it's all said and done. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down.
They ran that one well. And not only did they pick up a nice chunk of yardage on the screen, they sent a message to the...
And he's going to lose a yard or two. Taken down behind the line. Al Woods. Able to collapse the pocket and drop him for a loss of a yard. After the sack here, second and 11. From the gun, Mariota. And that one's going to be over everybody in the back of the end zone. It's incomplete. Corey Davis, the intended receiver, and it'll bring up third down. Titans are in for six, and the Titans are going to add on to their lead. The point was hooking, but he does make it through. And his guys will take a 10-point lead. Now here's Suckup out to kick it away. This is taken about 7 yards deep. Oh, a nice spin. And terrific field position here as they finally get him just shy of the midfield stripe.
Any return that gets you to midfield is a great return. One first down, and you're almost in field goal position.
They've got good starting field position as they come up here first and 10. From the shotgun, it's Taylor. And his throw is going to be incomplete. Eric Ebron, the big tight end, his intended target. That'll bring up second down. That one doesn't find its target, but all in all, he's been much sharper this week. He was under 50% a week ago, and now he's up over 70%.
But you know it's standard for quarterbacks and receivers to get together for a little extra time each and every day in practice. I get the sense they got together for a lot of extra time this week to try and improve that passing percentage, and it's worked out quite well.
Taylor incomplete on first down. Here's second and 10. To throw again. Taylor is going to fire one deep into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Dane Cruikshank, and he'll get this back to the 32-yard line.
Well, if you go by the numbers, you'll find as the temperature goes down, so does the passing efficiency. And now that we're in December, even the routine throws are going to be harder for the quarterbacks. And this one, it winds up getting picked off.
Throw left side complete. It's Bryant. 16 yards right off the bat and a first down. Right after the turnover, they come out throwing.
And that means it's a sudden change situation. We used to practice it on defense. Sudden change, get out there, stop the offense. But you typically run out there a little bit unsettled. I think that's why he came right out throwing the football, hoping to catch him off balance.
And he did. A gain of six there on first.
Well, it certainly feels like there are more stars at the tight end position than there were even 10 years ago. And I think it's become more of a glamour position because of the ways it can hurt a defense, and guys want to be involved. They can be in line, close to the line of scrimmage. They can split out like receivers. But hands, route running, speed, and some toughness to go across the middle, you put it all together, you got a heck of a tight end candidate.
From the 32 now, here's first and 10. First down, Mariota being shaken, and he's taken to the ground, but he was pulled down by the face mask. Here come the flags, and I believe this is going to be a first down. Give him six on the play, and now it's first and 10. A big mistake, especially when you factor in the personal foul yardage. On first and 10, here's Mariota. And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Picked off at the 19, and his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half. Well, that's three picks he's now thrown in this game.
And I know this, the holiday season. Honestly, here we are in December.
Season of giving.
Right, it is the season of giving. Maybe for his own sake, after the game, he may have to announce that he's donating certain amounts to charity for each interception that he throws.
He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out, incomplete. The throw by Taylor here, and that's incomplete. Taylor incomplete on first down. Here's second and 10. To throw is Taylor. Throwing again. Buying time to his left. Trying to get it to Ebron, and it's intercepted. Picked off at about the 31. And he will be brought down as time has now run out on this first half of action. We now proceed to the start of the second half. So we've come upon halftime here in week 17. The final two quarters of the NFL regular season are upon us as the second half of week 17 is underway. And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. Here's the Titan offense now as they make their way back onto the field. And with three interceptions thrown already, we'll see. Do they rely more on the ground game here?
They may have to change things offensively to try and settle things down, not just for the guy throwing the ball, but for the rest of the offensive unit, because his confidence has to be shaken a little bit. And you just wonder, is the backup going to start to warm up a little bit over on the sideline?
They'll start things on first down with Deion Lewis. First down yardage on the first play of the drive, 14 yards.
Sometimes it's hard to believe, but there are times this game is about patience, isn't it? Hasn't had the game he expected, but that run there, that may get him going.
I was just going to say, maybe that gives him a little juice, because you're right, he struggled, especially in that first half.
Yeah, and I know the great ones always think to themselves, just hang in there. I'm just one big carry away from busting this open. That's a good start for him.
Second down, here's Henry. And that play went nowhere. Losing yardage, it'll be back at the 36. Call that a loss of 5 yards on the play. And they're going to face an uphill battle here on third and long. Working out of the gun, Mariota. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And he'll be corralled out across midfield down to the 45. 7 catches for him now in this last one, a first down.
One.
A first down throw for Mariota. Looking left side, it's complete. He's got it. And he'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. He got 29 yards that time.
Some think the teams really won't throw a slant route unless you have a receiver that has a lot of stature to him. But sometimes the little guys, they get lost in there. People can't really locate them, and they run that quick cut on the slant, and oftentimes they can turn into big players.
And he'll be taken down at the 2-yard line. Back-to-back nice gains, that one for 14 yards and another first. Great mix of play calling so far. 3 runs, 3 passes. All 3 passes have been completions, first and goal.
I think on defense now, you have to almost take a chance. Rely on your scouting. Pick a play you think they would run here and just load up for it and see what happens.
He'll get it up the middle. Nothing doing there. They're going to wind up holding him at the 2. No gain there, and it's going to set up 2nd and goal. 2nd and goal, and they will try again from the 2-yard line. They'll run for it with Deion Lewis. And I think they stopped him again. They did at the 1-yard line. It'll go as no gain on the play, and now they're looking at a 3rd and goal. Touchdown, Tennessee. Deion Lewis, his 9th touchdown of the season. And the Titans find a way to stretch their lead.
That drive that really increased their cushion felt very military to me. Very precise, methodical. That's one of the words you've taught me. And they just got it done.
And slowly but surely now starting to pull away a little bit. Things looking good for them here in the 3rd quarter.
Not only pulling away, but you mentioned that slowly but surely, you also drain clock too with a drive like that. So you really give yourself an advantage.
Now here's Succop out to kick it away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Here's the Colts now as they get ready for their first possession on offense of the 2nd half. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in 3rd quarter, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half, other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. Give him 9 there on the first down completion. Maybe a good spot to take a shot. Here, second and a yard from the 34.
Ready. Flag for two.
Stepping up, he's going to keep it. And brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line. That's good for an Indianapolis first down on a gain of 10.
And that was a nice, strong run by the guy they call the field general.
Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down.
Slow, slow, slow.
Here's Hines. And this one's going to go the wrong way. Losing yardage back at the 42. That's going to go as a loss of 2, and it'll be second down.
I think it's pretty evident. We can say what a difference a week makes. Last week, he ran pretty much wild, didn't he? Did pretty much what he wanted to do. But this one, they stopped him cold. That, to me, that's good scouting and even better execution.
Yeah, and they stopped him behind the line right there. They obviously watched the tape a few times and made some adjustments. Taylor. Fourth, and he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Jarrell Casey in there to get him for sack number 9 now on the year. Third and long, Taylor and company hoping to regroup after the sack. Out of the gun, it's Taylor. That's caught out left by Perriman. And he'll get it down to the 47 here. They get 15, but they still need it a little bit more. Fourth down. Fourth down, here's Taylor. He's going to look deep for Perriman. And they will not be able to hook up there. It's incomplete. The Colts unable to convert here on fourth down. And as a result, it'll be Titan football on the turnover on downs. Mariota and the Titans break the huddle, first and 10 on their side of midfield at the 47. Start off with a give to Lewis. And very little running room there. He did get a couple up to the 49.
Well, we saw him there trying to get it to the outside, trying to get to the perimeter, but not a whole lot of room there. But there's got to be one positive to that. If you keep moving laterally, creases tend to develop as the game moves on, and they can run it back inside later.
Mariota now on second down. And that's going to be incomplete.
Now, the secondary's really struggled today, but that's a little bit of a measure of revenge, isn't it? And they just followed the basic rules. See ball, knock ball away, turned into a nice play.
On third down, Mariota. And this is going to be incomplete.
And that's a crusher right there. Had his man open for a first down, threw a fastball when that wasn't necessary. Incomplete pass. When are these quarterbacks going to learn? You don't get extra points for how hard you throw the football.
So here we go. The offense is going to stay out there. They're going for it on fourth and 8. They're indeed going. It's Mariota. Oh, a scrap of the football, and he's going to come down with it. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. Not often do fourth down conversions result in 23 yards, but that's the case here. First down. Mariota now to throw on first down. And that's incomplete. Corey Davis, the intended receiver. And that'll bring up second down.
Well, they're slinging it. And then there's one you got to put a timer on, huh? I mean, that one came in hot.
That came in hot, but overthrown, out of his reach and incomplete. So now they'll come up on second and 10, once again from the 28. They'll run it now out of the gun. And they've got it in the red zone now, down at about the 19. 9 yards on the pickup there as they'll be left with third and one.
Kid had a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one?
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end. Now Mariota. And too much on that one. It's out of the back of the end zone, incomplete.
So typically you'd say nice job defensively to force a decision on fourth down, but they've already gone for it once and converted, so you better make sure your defense stays out on the field and is alert.
Now, the offense not going anywhere. They're staying out there. They've converted once already on this drive. Here they go again on fourth down. From the shotgun, it's Mariota. And that is going to be incomplete. The Titans try it, but ultimately they fail on fourth down. And the Colts are going to take over with a football. Now the Colts offense gets ready to head back on the field. And this offense last time turned it over, went for it on fourth, didn't get it. They're lucky, though, because no points against the team on the board, but we'll see how they respond.
Yeah, they've got to get a lot of credit to their defensive teammates, don't they? They had their backs on that last series, and because they did so, that allows the coach to still stay aggressive on offense and maybe go for it again in a similar situation.
I was going to say, maybe makes that offense feel good, but when you know you've got a defense making stands like that.
Yeah, that'll loosen up things a little bit, won't it? Maybe you'll play a little bit better the next time you have the ball.
A big-time gain there on the keeper, using his legs to hurt him. First down. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's up over midfield and down into Tennessee territory. It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the third quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
Oh, now he bowls him over and brought down, but able to get it to their 30-yard line. That one for Indianapolis, resulting in 15 yards and a fresh set of downs.
So much for him being bottled up throughout the day. Finally finds a way to break through and get a really nice game. The defense has felt great about what they had going. Now they've got to turn their attention to getting it back in that direction. Can they bottle him up again? Because I'd say after that run, confidence is pretty high for him.
Back now in Nashville. It's the Colts, so they've got the football, but they've got work to do, trailing here as we begin the fourth quarter. Right. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. That's good for an Indianapolis first down on a gain of 10.
Well, that's the fear any defense has when the quarterback gets involved in the running game. You don't usually account for him, and he's hurting.
And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off at the 11, and he is going to get this one back to the 20-yard line.
Well, this defensive pressure has been constant all game long. The pass rush, the coverage, they've all been excellent, and now they'll tack on an interception here as this one continues to slip just further and further out of hand.
They go play action here on first down, sliding out of the pocket, and he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds. Successful start to the drive, 17 yards, and moves the sticks. Still throwing the football here, even with the big lead.
Yeah, I know you and I came up in a different era, and we think about sportsmanship and all that. Other people think about fantasy points and getting there.
But his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off at the 46. And he'll return this ball across midfield to the 47-yard line. Just a little bit of a rough stretch. Six interceptions now in these last 2 weeks combined.
I know the easy thing is to go back to mechanics, footwork, things of that nature. I'm also wondering, is he getting fooled by what he's seeing on defense? Has the scouting report changed or the shoulder?
And now on the pitch, the ball's loose. But I believe the Colts were able to fall on this when they were, and so possession will remain with Indy.
On plays like this, when the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back. Because this is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
They'll get five out of the keeper, but now it's third down. Play fake. Here's Taylor. He's going to loft it deep right sideline. That's incomplete, but there is a flag down. So hang on. A big call coming on third down. T.Y. Hilton, the intended receiver. So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. And now he'll tuck it and run. 2 yards the gain on the keeper, and it's second down.
And if you like defensive football, focus on the defensive end on this play. He does everything exactly right. Reads the play and makes sure he spills it for a small gain.
Call it no gain on the keeper, and it's going to bring up a third down.
Sometimes play calls boil down to philosophy. You know you're facing one of the top 10 units against the run in the NFL. So do you decide to keep smashing against them, or do you decide to throw the ball here?
Here's Taylor. And probably the wise decision there. No one open. He just throws it away. And that keeps the field goal on the table as it's fourth down.
Sometimes it's just not your day. There's another failure right there on third down.
Here we go. It's Taylor on fourth down. That is caught. It's Perriman. And all the way down inside the 5 to the 4. Some collective exhales over there on the sideline. A big pickup through the air on fourth down to bring up first and goal. And that is caught. Touchdown, Indianapolis. Eric Ebron, his first touchdown on the year. And the Colts use the short field to their advantage as they cash in for 6. Vinatieri now for the point after. Extra point, hugged the upright a bit, but he gets it to go. And that will shave one more off this lead. Vinatieri out there to kick this one away. Charles, you'd said the magic number was probably right around 20 for this defense because they're facing one of the top 5 offenses in the league in terms of points scored. They've had their moments, but this offense, just a little too good, isn't it?
They really are, because no matter what you do to make an adjustment on defense, they've had an answer for it.
Mariota and the Titans break the huddle, first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. Rolling to his right. Going deep here for... And got his man, complete! To the end zone for a Tennessee touchdown. Dez Bryant with touchdown number 7 on the year. And the Titans are going to add on to their lead. Extra point up and good by Succa. And that'll make this a 3-score game now. The lead moves to 17. Now here's Succa out to kick it away. No return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. And now Indianapolis set to take the field. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
Z, 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 Z.
On first down, it's Taylor. He's going to air one out. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. Second and 10 now, it's Taylor. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And some room to run now. And now off to the races, down the right side. Touchdown, Indianapolis. Naeem Hines, his 14th touchdown now on the year. And the Colts are able to cut into this lead. And it's no good. It has not been his day. That's the second extra point he's missed so far. Vinatieri out there to kick this one away. And here comes Tennessee as they get set to take the field. And following that long touchdown pass, a one-play drive last time, see if the defense, you know they're ready. They don't want that to happen again.
And you would have thought they would have been ready the last time. That's what you work on all the time. Make sure that no one gets behind you. That's the cardinal sin of defense, not giving up the long pass. They did. Let's see how they adjust.
And the first play of the drive there is incomplete.
You get a tight end like this, and you know he's used to dishing out punishment, but here, he's one that has absorbed the contact, and as a result, unable to hold on to the football.
Looking left sideline, but it's incomplete.
Had an open man that time, but ended up putting a little too much heat on it, don't you think, partner?
Absolutely, just needed a touch more air under it. Instead, he fired an absolute bullet. Mariota from the gun on third down. Steps away to his left. He completes it to Bryant. And he's got the first down yardage before being taken down at midfield. A really nice gain of 25 yards. They'll run it now out of the gun. And they go backwards here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down.
Brandon, it's clearly a running situation when you're up in the fourth quarter. They're going to have to stack the box and make it difficult for them to move the ball.
Made it very difficult right there, and now they need to repeat that effort.
Yeah, bring 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take to slow them down.
To throw Mariota. Boy, stays out. Shreds the tackle. Looking downfield for... And intercepted. Maybe the turning point they need. Picked off at the 15. And he brings it back to right around the 26-yard line. Charles, whatever's going on between his ears right now, it's just not completely calculated correctly. 7 picks between last week and this week after that one.
And they always say the most important part of a player is those 6 inches between the ears. But right now, it's all those interceptions that are going on. So whoever his trusted confidant is on the sidelines, I don't know if it's the offense coordinator, quarterback's coach, maybe the backup quarterback, that's who he needs to get with now and get himself calm.
On second down, Taylor. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back. Complete. And all the way down to the 22-yard line. A big play there on the catch and run. 48 yards. They'll throw on first down with Taylor. That is caught at the 7. Another nice gain, 16 yards there, and a first down again. This offense can certainly move quickly when they want to. 3 plays, 3 pass completions, in the blink of an eye, they've got a first and goal.
Almost felt like a lightning bolt hitting this game, didn't it, for them to get downfield that quickly? And now first and goal, expect them to tap right here on this play.
Now a throw to the end zone on first down, but it winds up incomplete. Throwing again, it's Taylor. And that one almost intercepted. Far too loose with the football here. Nearly a 4th pick, and it's 3rd down.
trying to decipher what's going on out there, because I don't know if he's just getting bad reads. I don't know if the defense is confusing him. I don't know if he just has, you know, bad info and intel before he snaps the ball. But he's made some pretty bad decisions with the football lately.
Yeah, several bad decisions on the interceptions he's thrown, and frankly, that should have been another pick right there. Dancing to his left. And that will be incomplete as well. How about the defensive stand here from first and goal? Three straight incompletion.
Yeah, I think people are wondering, why didn't they try and run it at least once in there? But once the first incompletion happened, it's almost like they were committed to throwing the ball from then on out.
Now on fourth down, we've got a whistle here and a timeout. It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. So a field goal gets you back within a score, but they're going to go for the bigger chunk here. Kicking team on the sidelines. Offense on for fourth down. Got to try it here. He's back to throw. Being chased out left. And that is incomplete. They can't hook up here on the fourth down pass attempt. And as a result, it'll be Titan football on the turnover on downs. They start the drive on the ground with Lewis. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. Defensively, no doubt they need a quick stop. Offensively here, maybe do you put it in the air on second down, or do you go ahead and keep it on the ground, keep that clock moving?
A lot of people would ask that question, partner, because sometimes throwing the ball might actually be the path of least resistance. But in this case, it's a matter of trust. How much do you trust your quarterback? Because you throw the ball and it goes awry, you really don't look smart as a coach.
Yeah, and then you stop that clock. Time for a break. We're back to finish this one off after this. Now, this is a big third down, and you'd have to think we'd see a timeout right away if they can't stop him here. On third and one, here's Mariota. Sets up the screen to Lewis. Lewis has the first down and then some. And he takes it all the way up to the 47. And another timeout taken by the Colts. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. The big play has him all the way out near midfield for a first and 10. Mariota to throw it. He'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. And he loses the football a second time. And the Colts pick it up. And they will set up shop at their own 46-yard line.
Well, that's one of those mistakes. That's a fumble that when they get to the sidelines, I know you're mad, coach, but look, we still got this locked down, but that's not necessarily true, is it?
Well, their hopes are slim, but you just hate to give them any hope. You could have sealed it right there.
Yeah, could have finished them off and then taken away all hope, as we like to say.
The drive starting with a first down, 11 yards on that pickup. First down now, but that clock rolling.
Looks to me, partner, like he's learned a little bit, because earlier in the game, I think he's trying to force a lot of throws into his windows that just weren't open.
Yeah, the interceptions had plagued him, especially a second interception, really a bad throw, so maybe a better decision there.
Yeah, no doubt about it. I think he learned from earlier in the game, and he's applying it now.
Now Taylor to throw on second down. And his throw here is incomplete. The pro. Wideout Julio Jones is intended receiver, and it's third down.
Z.
From the shotgun, it's Taylor. And he connects with Ebron. It'll be a gain of 17 and an Indianapolis first down. First down now, but the clock continues to move. Of course, remember, you need a touchdown here and a field goal.
Doesn't matter the order, but they have to get it done and get it done fast.
Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done. Chewing up big yardage. Another nice gain there. This one goes for 20. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit them, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. Again, it's Taylor. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off by the USC man, Adoree Jackson. He's at the 50. He's at the 30. The 20. 10. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. And that one will pretty much erase any hopes of a fourth quarter comeback.
With emphasis, interception, return for touchdown. Door closed, locked, reinforced.
Extra point put through by Suckup, and the lead is up to 18 now. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. This is fielded at the goal line. A nice little juke. And a nifty return there as he's all the way up past the 40-yard line.
At some point, we're going to get it through our heads. Special teams, special teams, special teams. The spark that often wins games.
Good starting field position for the Colts as they have it first and 10. To begin the drive, here's a handoff to Hunt. And he'll be brought down, losing yardage back at the 40. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
Well, that's pretty symptomatic about how things have gone here. That play was just shut down right from the start.
And not going to give him a lot of confidence to help turn things around. He's going to let it fly. And now here's another interception. Picked up by Dane Cruikshank. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. The interception woes, they just continue to mount. He's thrown five picks. At this point, you got to be thinking, is it something between the ears?
I think a confidence hit does occur.
And he's going to go down. Back at his own five-yard line, it's a sack. And what are the whistles for? Timeout. So they'll stop the clock here in a game that's been decided in the closing seconds. Mariota here to throw. And he can't get away. Mariota goes down, and that is going to be a safety.
And you know, the man who sat in my chair the last few years, he has a theory. These plays, these safeties, they're so rare. Maybe they should be worth more than two, maybe 4 points.
I think he's got a great point. I really do, Brandon. But I would go ahead and up it to six. I'm a former defender. Oh. To me, that's like scoring a touchdown.
Easy now. I'll go four. I don't know about six.
Come on, come on. Come up to six.
A lot of points.
One last shot for Taylor. Taylor hit. He lost the football. And that might be Titan football. It is. But Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Boy, were they clicking on offense.
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feel like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can follow this and carry it with them.
And as an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.
So for Tennessee, a final win here means they'll finish at 14-2. And now they'll have the week off as they get set to go after a Super Bowl title. Meanwhile, for Indianapolis, we'll have to see what happens as they're going to finish.
Can you hear me now? shirts, louder than the broccoli, dancing in my chucks, living out of body, say to say the man got me.
Can you hear me?
Spitting to my clutch drive, need some power steering, cruising to a better vision, y'all.
Can you hear me?
Baby, I know I'm wrong, but this just how life goes. And I know these
AP on all of my. I like when they wet on their toes. Picture me riding around in that rose. I put some ice on my wrist, it was walls. Feel like I got it with you.
Johnny Big Redemption, like, know what I'm talking about? Hold up.
Whoa, 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 whoa.
Whoa. Nothing to something, whoa. I won. Get out the way, get out the way. Get